Hi, my name is Ming Yao from Singularity Engineering. In this video, I will be showing you how to bring a complex board with hundreds of components from Sherlock into ANSYS for analysis. Here I'm loading in an ODB++ file, and we'll do a quick analysis on this PCB board. So Sherlock is a easy to use and very powerful pre and post processing tool that allows us to set up a simulation quickly for ANSYS analysis. It's designed to handle electronics reliability problems very efficiently. We're automatically bringing in all of the layers of the PCB, and we can go from the part list to identify and modify each parts. Sherlock has a library of parts as well as material properties, and it makes educated guesses based on the names of the parts to apply the appropriate material properties to these parts. You can see that all of the parts are automatically populated with the package name, location, as well as the materials. Sometimes it may not be able to decide what kind of components these are, but we can easily modify this. So let's go ahead and assign a material to this. I'll put in a leaded over mold for this material, for this part. So now that material has been defined for these parts. Next, we can take a look at the stack ups. Sherlock automatically imports all of the layers. It defines them as either laminate and signal, and it calculates appropriate dimensions and material properties. In the current iteration, it does not import the thicknesses of this, of each layer, so these need to be inputted by hand for ODB++ files. It will import layer information for ODB XML files, and I was told that we will soon be able to import information for the ODB++ files as well. So here, let me input the appropriate thickness of each layer. Let's update the copper and go ahead and begin to define the layers. The key challenge of simulating electronics PCB boards is how complex they are. There are hundreds of components on this model, and creating the geometry on something like this by hand or through normal CAD tools can be very time consuming and difficult. Sherlock allows us to quickly and easily modify this, so we can start. It automatically builds a 3D geometry based on the information from the PCB, the component, the height, etc. However, there could sometimes be issues. For example, here I'm looking at both the silkscreen and the components on the top layer. And this one is obviously rotated incorrectly. This one as well. So let's rotate these two to ensure that they're aligned. There are overlaps. For example, this is a board that should not be there, so we can delete that. Go ahead and delete this part. We can also resize parts. For example, this is a card slot. We can drag the corners here and make it a little bit smaller. So you can see it's very easy and quick to adjust the geometry until the components are aligned properly. So it's warning me that this part BT400 is overlapping another circuit board. So I can put that into the analysis to show that this is the part that's overlapping. Take a look at the model, and you can see there's a slight overlap between these two components. So again, I can adjust the size of this component a little bit, so that's no longer overlapping. Now it says K700 is overlapping here. So let's turn off the top. Look at the silk screen down here. So let's look for K700. So that component over here has an overlap. Right, you can see that this component is much larger than its silk screened area, so we will modify this by dragging it over here. Okay, that fixes the overlapping issues, and we can see that all of the components are aligned properly. This type of quick setup allows us to cover hundreds of components and make sure they're all placed properly very quickly. There's a pick place option. The other things that we should look at are the mechanical supports. These are done used in the cutout, in the mount point location. So you can see that Sherlock automatically assigns mount points to larger holes. However, these are not all real mount points. They're often drill holes for connectors and things like that. So really there are just a four mount points in the corners. Maybe this is another one. So let's go ahead and adjust the mount points. So we can, for example, select the areas that we believe are not mount points. We can go ahead and delete these. Delete the locations. Now we're ready to transfer the model from Sherlock into ANSYS Workbench. We go back to the original Sherlock screen, and we can click on any of the simulation options. Let's go to random vibration analysis. If we go to the random vibrations analysis, we can export an FEA model. This allows us to export a Workbench journal file as well as the associated information. So I'm going to select this file and export, overwriting the existing file. We don't need a mesh for this, so we can go ahead and turn that off. And that allows us to bring the model into ANSYS Workbench. Now that we've exported a script file from Sherlock, we can import that into an ANSYS Workbench project. We're going to run the script that Sherlock has created for us. This automatically builds a geometry, it imports all of the material properties, and brings that into a Workbench environment. So we can see that here is engineering data with all the material properties for each part. We have the geometry brought in from a step file, and we're going to edit that geometry using Design Modeler. So this particular model has 680 parts, so it's a fairly large assembly. And obviously, modeling an assembly like this by hand would be extremely time-consuming. But here we have all the geometry created in Sherlock brought into ANSYS simulation. I selected all the layers of PCB and turned that into a multi-body part. That allows us to quickly set up a simulation, and it means that we don't have any contact elements, so we have conformal mesh through the PCB. We can start with a basic modal analysis, but now that you're in the ANSYS Workbench environment, we can do a wide range of simulations from harmonic to response spectrum, transient simulation, random vibrations, or static analysis for thermomechanical simulations. There are many methods to do things like shock analysis. One of the nice capabilities is to do a modal superposition transient simulation. This allows us to do a time domain transient analysis very quickly. Now you can see that all of the components have been imported into ANSYS Workbench through Sherlock. However, the material properties are not set yet. They're using the default structural steel. What we did here is that we're reading in a Python script generated by Sherlock that then automatically maps all the material properties to each component as well as create a name selection for each part so that Sherlock can identify which component has the right amount of deflection and stress. Now that the script has completed, we can see that this capacitor in particular has the right material property set. This also applies to all the other components in our entire assembly. The next thing we want to do is to import the trace mapping. Trace mapping allows us to map the copper content of each layer of the PCB onto our mesh on an element by element basis. This gives us a very accurate prediction of the stiffness of the board. Now, when we're doing trace mapping, we have to be aware that in Sherlock, the board is generated from the center, whereas in ANSYS, we read the board in from the bottom. This means we have to displace the board in the Z orientation by half the thickness of the entire board. As you can see, now there's an option for import trace setup under the materials screen. We have to add a couple materials to the model, FR4 and copper alloy. This allows us to model the traces appropriately. We're going to assign the base material for all the layers of the PCB as FR4, and we're going to import the traces and map it onto the elements of the board. In trace mapping, there's an option to select the trace material. In this case, we'll make all of the trace material copper alloy. We can copy and paste to all of the layers. This means that the base material is FR4 for each layer and the trace material is FR4. ANSYS also imports all of the via locations. The vias can be solid vias or hollow vias, and you can again select the via material. There's 78 vias to be defined in this model, and we'll select all of them and set them all as copper alloy as well. With Workbench, we have all kinds of mesh settings available. Here we're going to assign a uniform mesh onto the PCB themselves. We'll assign a size of 4 millimeters. Now, because there's a huge number of elements, we want to mesh them efficiently. We'll select all of the edges of each element and split into 3 parts. ANSYS will automatically sweep mesh these elements to create hexahedral elements. So we'll have 3 elements across every direction for each part, no matter what size it is. Here, ANSYS uses parallel meshing to mesh all 680 parts. Once the mesh has been created, we can import the traces. This will now calculate the equivalent material property for each element within the PCB, giving us an accurate PCB material properties. We can review layer by layer the PCB mapping results. Red area shows locations with a lot of copper, whereas blue area shows areas with very little copper. Now I can set up a quick modal analysis, assign some fixed supports to the support mounts. We can visualize the results, and you can see that the simulation has been completed successfully. In this case, we've imported an assembly of 680 parts. We assigned the right material properties to all the components and performed trace mapping on the PCB itself. Thank you for watching this demonstration of Sherlock and ANSYS integration. If you have any questions regarding PCB reliability, feel free to contact us at Singularity Engineering. If you enjoyed this video, please like us on YouTube and join our channel. Thank you. Have a good day.